Hollywood, California. Bing Crosby entertains.
When your roundup days are over, there'll be pastures white with clover for you, old faithful Palomar.
The makers of Woodbury's facial soap for the skin you love to touch present Bing Crosby.
If I expected love when first we met, kiss, blame it on my youth. If only just for you I did exist, blame it on my youth. I believed in everything like a child of three. Meant more than anything, all the world to me. If you were on my mind all night and day, blame it on my youth. If I forgot to eat and sleep and pray, blame it on my youth. I cried a little bit when first I learned the truth. Don't blame it on my heart, blame it on my youth. On my mind all night and day, blame it on my youth. If I forgot to eat and sleep and pray, blame it on my youth. If I cried a little bit when first I learned the truth, don't blame it on my heart, blame it on my youth.
The other day, Paul Whiteman celebrated his 20th year as the Dean of Modern American Music. You know, I was lucky enough to work for Paul during some of this period, and I'd kind of like you to listen now to one of the songs with which he first started New York. Georgie Stoll and the orchestra playing Japanese Sandman.
Thank you.
A woman's complexion may not be the only important part of her attraction, but men seldom look twice at a girl who has permitted her skin to be marred by open pores, blackheads, oily shine, or coarse dryness. Tonight, we have asked Miss Janet Parker, Woodbury's well-known beauty consultant, to tell us why these blemishes occur and how to correct them. Miss Parker.
Every beauty specialist knows that the chief cause of common skin faults is neglect, and particularly neglect of the one fundamental essential to a fresh, clear complexion. The unpleasant fact is, many women do not get their skins really clean. Oh, I don't mean they're careless about bathing, but the methods they use just do not provide thorough, deep cleansing. And sometimes they even tend to clog the pores. Now, there are definite scientific reasons why Woodbury's facial soap does clear the pores of waste, embedded powder, and all trace of dirt. Woodbury's is more than just a dainty toilet soap. It is actually a complete beauty treatment created by a famous skin specialist to do two important things. First, its fine oils penetrate deep into the pores and loosen all foreign matter accumulated there. Then, other exclusive ingredients gently stimulate the tiny pore muscles to throw off obstructions that interfere with breathing. Did you know that your skin must be able to breathe to remain healthy and clear? And that's why women are often disappointed in the results they get from costly creams and lotions. Unless the pores are conditioned to receive the benefits of such preparations, you really might as well put them on a mask. So, no matter what your skin condition may be, its first and most vitally important need is a thorough pore cleansing provided by Woodbury's gently soothing formula. And in the majority of cases, this formula alone is all that is necessary to clear up and restore natural beauty to even advanced cases of common skin faults when used according to the special directions for each type of skin, which are wrapped with each cake of Woodbury. Thank you.
Some of you may have seen Here Is My Heart, and if you did, you'll recall with pleasure a young lady who graced the film, namely Marion Mansfield. She's here tonight and ready to sing the type of song that she really does best. What's the title, Marion?
Things Might Have Been So Different.
Well, proceed.
My days go by in meditation, just reminiscing now and then. And while I sigh in meditation, I find myself saying again and again, things might have been so different, different as night and day. If you hadn't said I love you, just to have something to say, things might have been so different, right from the very start. But you only wanted kisses, lips without any heart. Do roses ever remember December may find them gone? So why should sweethearts remember that love's little amber may fade with the dawn? Things might have been so different, we'd still be friends today, if you hadn't said I love you, just to have something to say. Why should sweethearts remember that love's little amber may fade with the dawn? Oh, things might have been so different, we'd still be friends today, if you hadn't said I love you, just to have something to say.
Very nice, Marion. I've had a couple of requests to repeat a song from my picture I'm in with Bill Fields and Joan Bennett, Mississippi, called Easy to Remember.
Your sweet expression, the smile you gave me, the way you looked when we met, it's easy to remember, but so hard to forget. I hear you whisper, I'll always love you. I know it's over, and yes, it's easy to remember, but so hard to forget. Oh, I must dream to have your hand caress me, fingers press me tight. I'd rather dream than have that lonely feeling stealing through the night. Each little moment is clear before me, and though it brings me regret, it's easy to remember, but so hard to forget. Your sweet expression, the smile you gave me, the way you looked when we met, easy to remember, so hard to forget. I hear you whisper, I'll always love you. I know it's over, and yes, easy to remember, oh, so hard to forget. So I must dream to have your hand caress me, fingers press me tight. I'd rather dream than have that lonely feeling stealing through the night. Each little moment is clear before me, and though it brings it's easy to remember, but so hard to
thank you. man outside. Says he's one of your fans. He insists on seeing you. Shall I send him in?
Why, certainly, sir. I'm always glad to see any of my fans. Well, 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 how are you? I'm glad to see you. How have you been?
I'm very well, thank you. How are you? Not that I'm particularly interested, but it makes conversation. How are you, one and all? Remember me?
Why, sure I remember you. Last time I saw you was in Pittsburgh.
No, I never was in Pittsburgh in my life.
Well, never mind. You're looking great, though. A little thinner, aren't you?
No, this is the stoutest I have ever been. You don't remember me.
Certainly I do. Don't you remember that week we were in Buffalo?
No, I don't. I never was in Buffalo.
Well, anyhow, you're looking great. But you took off that little stash you had, didn't you?
No, I didn't, because I never wore a mustache in my life. You don't remember me.
No, I guess I don't. I don't remember you. Who are you?
I'm your brother John. When are you going to write home to Mama?
Oh, there you go. Always kidding. I know you all the time. You're Charlie Irwin. I knew your kisser was familiar.
Well, it ought to be. I've had it for years and years.
Well, it used to be sort of a tired face. You've had something done to it, haven't you?
Yes. As a matter of fact, now that you've brought it up, I had it lifted once, but dropped twice.
Well, how have you been? You know, I haven't seen you since that time on my vacation.
I wasn't there. What would I be doing on your vacation?
Now, there you again. What were you doing in California?
California? I thought this was Kansas City. I knew I should have got off that train 2 days ago.
Well, now that you're here, did you leave New York for arrest?
No, I left New York to avoid arrest.
Did your wife come with you?
Don't be silly.
How about your wife's mother?
Oh, she's up in Alaska. I sent her up there on a long vacation.
Hey, isn't it awfully cold up in Alaska right now?
Why, certainly it's cold. Right now, it's 50 below zero.
Don't you think, you know what I mean, a lady of her age, don't you think the climate will disagree with her?
The climate disagree with my wife's mother? It wouldn't dare.
Well, no joking now, Charlie. What did you come out to California for?
Well, as a matter of fact, I came out here to watch the horses run at Santa Anita.
I like to see them run, too.
Yeah, but the trouble is, when I bet on them, they just go out for a little stroll. I bet on one nag there one day, if he hadn't speeded up a little bit in the stretch, he'd have won the next race. But I like those windows out there. You know, the windows that mark $2, $5, $10, $50, so forth and so on. And you go up to any one of these windows and you purchase tickets on a horse. And then you tear them up. It's a game. You know, they have what they call the mutual system of betting. I've always been under the impression that that word mutual in the English language meant one for him, one for her, one for me. No, it's all for them.
But of course, Charlie, you must have bet on the winner of the big handicap.
Listen, Mr. Valley, I'm the only one who didn't bet on the winner of the handicap. I bet on the horse that ran last. I heard the owner talking to the jockey after the race. He gave him a terrible lashing. He said, why didn't you obey my orders? I told you to give him his head in the back stretch. I told you to take him to the outside and move up with the leaders at the mile and turning into the stretch for home. Why didn't you go up there and join those other jockeys? And the jockey said, what, and leave the horse? Well, Mr. Valley, it certainly has been a great pleasure seeing you.
Mr. Valley, sir, listen, who do you think I am?
Well, you're Rudy Valley. Oh, no, of course not. How could I make a mistake like that? Valley's much darker. Besides, he has a mustache. Well, you'll pardon me, Mr. Cantor. How do you think of all those jokes you tell on the radio?
Listen, my name isn't Cantor, and I don't tell jokes. I think so.
Oh, then you don't have to think.
How?
Well, it's my mistake, Mr. Tibbet. You know, I have the most terrible memory for names. It's a family affliction. You know, I have a brother worse than any of us.
Oh, yeah? What's his name?
He won't tell us. Well, I'll be going now, and you must forgive me for not remembering your name. It's been on the tip of my tongue all evening, and it's the simplest name in the world to remember.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Jack Okey. Well, so long, Mr. Okey.
That was the unkindest cut of all.
You may be surprised to learn that the most popular cowboy song of the day was written, introduced, and proved highly popular in England. Such is indeed the case, and it's proved equally popular over here.
Oh, faithful,
we rode the reins together.
Oh, faithful,
in every kind of weather. When your roundup days are over, there'll be pastures white with clover for you, oh faithful Palomar.
Hurry up, old fellow, 'cause the moon is yellow tonight. Hurry up, old fella, 'cause the moon is mellow and bright. There's a coyote howling to the moon above, so carry me back to the one I love. Hurry up, old fella, 'cause we gotta get home tonight. Oh, faithful in every kind of weather. When your roundup days are over, there'll be pastures white with clover for you. Faithful Alma.
I urge every woman who is not entirely satisfied with her complexion to read carefully the booklet on skin care, which is wrapped with each cake of Woodbury's facial soap. It is written by leading skin specialists and gives priceless information about how to correct and avoid the common types of skin blemishes. Of course, if you have any major skin fault, you must see a good dermatologist. But for ordinary conditions, such as large pores, blackheads, sallowness, oily shine or dry skin and premature wrinkles, you will be delighted with the quick results and the lovely new skin beauty you will obtain by following the simple instructions enclosed with each cake of Woodbury's.
Thank you, Miss Parker. Woodbury's is sold by all drug, department, and 10-cent stores, and at your grocer's, too. Now, don't let its low price deceive you regarding its quality. At today's price of only 10 cents, Woodbury's is identically the same fine complexion soap that formerly sold for 25 cents. And the booklet on care and correction of common skin faults, which is wrapped with each cake of Woodbury's, is alone worth many times the small price of the soap. Try Woodbury's, and the skin you love to touch will be yours.
Here's a product of those outstanding tunesmiths, Al Dubin and Harry Warren. One I consider among the best day of fashion. Lullaby of Broadway.
Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway. Hip-a-ray and ballyhoo, the lullaby of Broadway. The rumble of a subway train, the rattle of the taxi, the daffodils who entertain, and Angelo's and matches. Where the Broadway baby says goodnight, it's early in the morning. Manhattan babies don't sleep tight until the dawn. Good night, baby. Good night. Milkman's on his way. Sleep tight, baby. Sleep tight. Let's call it a day. Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway. Hi-de-ho and poobadoo, the lullaby of Broadway. Band begins to go to town, and everyone goes crazy. You rock a bye of baby round, till everything gets hazy. Hush, bye, I'll buy you this and that. You hear a daddy say, baby goes home to her flat to sleep all day. Good night, baby. Good night, milkman's on his way. Sleep tight, baby. Sleep tight, let's call it a day. Oh, listen to the lullaby of old Broadway.
Tonight, Tonight, you may try the famous Woodbury's facial soap and three other delightful beauty aids by sending for Woodbury's Loveliness Kit. This contains a guest-sized cake of the facial soap, cubes of the germ-free beauty cream, cold and facial, and all six shades of Woodbury's facial powder. Just send 10 cents in coin or stamps to cover cost of packing and mailing. Print your name and address on a slip of paper and send it to Woodbury's, Box 80. That's Box 80, Cincinnati, Ohio. Return mail will bring you your loveliness kit. Bing Crosby, Georgie Stoll, and his orchestra will be with you again next Tuesday evening. Join us and hear Bing sing...
Clouds floating through the night, speaking of a love that was heavenly, a love that could never be mine.
Ken Niles speaking for the makers of Woodbury's facial soap. This is the Columbia Broadcasting System.